It's your partner, man. Who? He don't talk about. It's your partner, man. Who? He don't talk about. It's your partner, man. Who? He don't talk about. Look, bro, on the go this morning, man. So this is gonna be a. It might be a long video. I'm just on the go. You know what I'm talking about. So y'all know my disclaimers. But first of all, what's good with that penitentiary, man? He don't know what I'm talking about, man. Shout out to the penitentiaries around this around the world, bro. You know what I'm talking about. Everybody on the bottom of that thing. Everybody on top of that thing. Ha ha, Ken in the pen, man. All my folks incarcerated, all my folks swaying, everybody on bottom of that thing, everybody on top of that thing. Keep that head up, keep pushing. We gonna get through it to get to it, man. You know what I'm talking about? Did I say Ken in the pen? You know what I'm talking about? What if I didn't? Go get that stick up in stores now. You go get you some more 76 MacArthur Giants Liquors. What I'm talking about, 82nd Hillside Barbershop. You know what I'm talking about? They say they put them in their stores in the hundreds. Thank you, young man. Now you know. You know what I'm talking about? You can come get them from me. Stick up, you know what I'm talking about. And if all else fails, man, go get you a also in stores. Funk or die trying, man. But if all fails, man, make sure you go get you a hardback, you know, and Dugu in them, man. Shout out to the penitentiaries around this world, man. A Dugu, Mike Cutthroat, Lil Rue, not Lil Rue, Lil Rue. You know what I'm talking about? Ta-ta the player, that's who comes next. Same thing, man. All my folks incarcerated. Keep that head up. You know what I'm talking about? Keep pushing. We gonna get through it to get to it. Now look, man, I don't promote no drug users. Don't promote no drug sellage. Don't promote no alcohol consumption. Don't do it. You know what I'm talking about? Don't take a sip of the sippage. I don't, good brother like myself, I don't promote no crime. I don't promote no violence. I don't promote no domestic violence. You know what I'm talking about? Keep your hands off the people. People. You know what I'm talking about? I don't promote no negativity. Nah, man. Me, all I don't promote. You know what I'm talking about? They was talking to me, man. I don't promote shit. You know what I'm talking about? All I promote is y'all. Go ahead, do what you're going to do with your time, young ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you find the right thing. Do it your time, young ladies and gentlemen, because we just don't know how much of it we got. But you better like myself. I'm not prejudiced. Don't got nothing against the sexually different. Don't got nothing against the little people. I ain't got nothing against nobody. You know what I'm talking about? They was talking to me. I love everybody. You know what I'm talking about? Matter of fact, I'm on a quest. You know what I'm talking about? Bring that peace. You know what I'm talking about? That joy. You know what I'm talking about? That love. Who did they read that love? You know what I'm talking about? Back to YouTube community, man. You with me? Come on over here and mess with your partner, man. Y'all hold on. I gotta go put some warmth on this Coffee Chronicles, man. You know what I'm talking about? Y'all hold on real quick. It's good with the people, man. Had to put some of that piping hot on that classic roast, man. Yeah, I had to put some of that piping hot on that classic roast. And said, shout out to all the unsure people who know they're going to slap the shit out you if you say something else to them. What'd you say? Yeah, I see. Man, it was good with the people, man. How is y'all doing? I ain't never gave y'all the name for this one. How is y'all doing on Forever Fault Friday? You say Forever Fault Friday. What you talking about, bro? Oh, just that right there. Forever Fault. You know what I'm talking about? Somebody gonna say, no, bro, I don't know what you're talking about. Could you elaborate? Why, certainly. Nephew, sis, old man, old lady. Nephew, sis, old man, old lady. Hey, what's up, bro, old lady? Just Forever Fault, man. You know what I'm talking about? We living at we living in the day right here. Ain't gonna say, bro, here you go. Always talking about we living in the day. You know what I'm talking about? We is. We living in the day of that Forever Fault, man. You say the Forever Fault, what's that? You just know how nowadays, bro, the most important thing is to find what you at fault for. You know what I'm talking about? It might not even be nothing significant. But we just got into a motherfucking world to where it's just forever fault. That's how we live. You know what I'm talking about? It ain't never our fault, but it's a forever fault. So we just go around and we collect other people's faults. And we try to tell other people where they wrong at, or we pointing to other people where they wrong at. And a lot of that shit don't even be no significance. You say, what you mean by that, bro? Now, I'm just talking about me. You might not fuck with it like this. But if it ain't no life-altering shit, I ain't gonna even let you know where your fault is, bro. You know what I'm talking about? Unless your fault, you either could hurt yourself, nigga, or you could get some bad results. I'm not going to point out your fault. You know what I'm talking about? It being your fault is not that significant. You get what I'm saying? it's just certain shit to where you at fault at that you might have to pull a motherfucker to the side, because them being at fault right there might be instrumental to them down the road. You know what I mean? Like, say you, I don't know, you a kid or something, you get caught stealing. You know what I'm talking about? You get caught stealing, or you get, I don't know, you get caught doing something that might be detrimental to you down the line. Then we have a talk. We might have a talk or something, bro. You know what I'm talking about? But I'm not finna make no big ass thing, bro, because you put the motherfucking plate where the bowls go. That's something I just put the plate back myself, bro. I'm not gonna call you up in there and make that the biggest thing in on the fight party. You know what I'm talking about? We up in here trying to watch Terrence Crawford and Spence fight, but I'm over here trying to point out a motherfucking fault where to let you know you didn't put the plates where the bowls go. You know what I'm talking about? And we do that shit a lot right there. Forever Fault Friday. To where they got us in a motherfucking thing to where we just looking for right and wrong as we see it. You know what I mean? But we trying to find everybody else's fault. And then, what's that word? Counsel them on their fault. You know what I mean? So you got a lot of that shit around here. I done seen friends to where, like, they just live to that shit. Like, my little niece and them, and daughter and them age. I done seen to where they just sit around all day pointing out each other faults and shit. Oh, you didn't, you know what I'm talking about? It was almost like a, remember that game? Nah, y'all might not be this old, but we used to play a game. We was little, like my car, your car, looking at Beetlebug, Slugbug, face having ass, you know what I'm talking about? Coffee Chronicles. And Forever Fault is fucked up because y'all done put so much on the fault that nobody wants to be at fault. You know what I mean? So even when the motherfucker is at fault, they go on the cover up, you know what I'm talking about, to make it not be their fault. Because, like, if it's your fault now, y'all act like that's a death sentence. You know what I mean? And that's another good way not to make no adjustment on yourself. Because I'm going to tell you what I've been seeing people do since I've been little. Nephew, sis, old man, old lady. Nephew, sis, old man, old lady. You know what I'm talking about? And shout out to everybody who came through the live last night. Shout out to 903 Boxing, you know what I'm talking about? Shout out 903 Boxing. I told you, besides myself, that's one of my favorite channels on this month. When it comes to sports, that's my favorite channel on this motherfucker. You know what I'm talking about? I promise you. I just love a motherfucker who ain't scared to tell your motherfucking ass what it is. And fuck y'all, I love that shit, man. You know what I'm talking about? I love a motherfucker who don't bite their tongue and shit, bro. That nigga had me. I'm going to tell you, that nigga had me. Because the first time I buzzed in on him was when Nephew lost. You know what I'm talking about? And the first 4-5, nigga, all the people that I might put my eye on, you know what I'm talking about? All them niggas was down to Nephew, and I didn't get that. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about, it seemed like the whole boxing world turned against little Nephew, nigga, in one night, right? And bro was the only one who wasn't on that bullshit. It was like two channels. It was him and my other nigga, Goodfella. You know what I mean? But it was only like two channels that I had seen that really wasn't on, that wouldn't own Nephew like that, and they just kept it real. You know what I mean? Like, nigga was like, man, first of all, Nephew and then was out of pocket for even fighting when that nigga was overweight. You know what I mean? Because I like them channels too. Like, I like people who, like, you'll like somebody, but you're not biased. I mean, you might be biased because you like them more than somebody else, but you still gonna tell the truth about your person too. You know what I'm talking about? I love that shit right there, folks. Because even the people we like, they ain't always right. You know what I'm talking about? But I love a motherfucker who could just keep it real, bro. Like, this is my favorite, boxer right here. This nigga be doing some bullshit sometimes. You know, I just like that shit, bro. Just that authentic, genuine shit, bro. You know what I'm talking about? I do. You know what I'm talking about? There ain't enough of that shit around here no more. Shout out 903. Oh, I'm gonna tell you when that nigga had me, though. Like I said, man, when Nephew lost, right? It was only, like I seen, only two channels, nigga. You know what I'm talking about? That really had his back. So I tapped in on him, man. And that nigga said, it ain't enough baby powder in the world, right? That nigga had me right there. I ain't bullshit with you. That nigga said, it ain't enough baby powder in this motherfucking world. You know what I'm talking about? to slap the shit out you niggas with it, man. But shout out, bro. Thank you, you know what I'm talking about? That man got some good content over there, man. And it just ain't enough of that shit. It ain't forever fault. It ain't enough motherfuckers willing to be they motherfucking self. You know what I'm talking about? And that's bad right there. And I know this might be off subject a little bit, man. But they done got us into the world to where that's how so many Sagoonies floating around this motherfucker. I told you, bruh. Y'all done got so used to, like, trying to show these white people you not a threat. You done turned yourself into Cinderella. You done piped yourself all the way down to the point where your wrist got flimsy. You know what I'm talking about? But you doing that trying to show these other people you ain't no threat, man. Y'all better stay loud and proud. Stay loud and proud. And I was just over there talking to my mama. My mama would just say some shit like that. Like, she can't believe how the world is now. You know, she came from the Black Panthers and Angela Davis and them. When everybody had afros and shit, niggas went wearing eyelashes and you was proud of your people. You know what I'm talking about? She said the way this world is today is just crazy. You know what I'm talking about? She can't believe it. Now, I'm only 47 and I've been living a while and I done seen this motherfucker change. I seen the world change 3 times. So I know she done been watching this motherfucker change forever. You know what I'm talking about? But forever fault, man. It's that right there, folks. Yeah, it's that thing right there, folks. It's that's what we look for now. We look for it to be your fault. And then we always trying to get out of it being ours. Even when it is. You know what I mean? Forever fault. And the reason that's not good for you, because, nigga, if you don't understand that it's your fault, you ain't gonna never learn, nigga. I gotta live with something right now, nigga, that I realize will, that I think that is my fault, bruh. You know what I'm talking about? Despite what happened or whatever, I feel like it's my fault, bruh. And I gotta live with something, bruh, that, y'all don't get it, man. You know what I'm talking about? You'll never understand shit, bruh. You'll never understand shit until it is your fault. You won't get to the meaning of that shit. Because once you start realizing your fault, then you can change it, folks. But when you don't realize it's your fault, it's going to keep being your fault. I ain't bullshitting with you. I'm telling you, but I'm sure y'all can see that on occasion. You know what I'm talking about? Especially when I was drinking. I've always been an irritating, agitating ass motherfucker, bruh. I ain't bullshitting with you. I'm one of them niggas that I'm not going to shut up. I'm always going to be around. Like, I'm just one of them niggas, bruh. You know what I'm talking about? So motherfuckers ain't, you know what I'm talking about? Motherfuckers never really did. I got to be I'm a required taste, bruh. I ain't bullshitting with you. This hella motherfuckers ain't never liked it, bruh. You know what I'm talking about? Bruh, irritate, man. Bruh going to get on your nerves. Bruh going to show up and lean on you. I ain't bullshitting. Bruh not going to shut up. I told you, we used to sneak in parties. I ain't bullshitting with you. I keep telling you. One day with that, I don't remember where as well. We was on the 109th, though, was it Cherise? That club that's behind the Hickory Pit. Y'all don't remember one of the Lacey people threw their party there? I don't know who party it was. One of the Lacey people was throwing their party there. But the people was IDing us, and all the Lacey niggas went in and passed their IDs to us. Nigga, ain't one person from the turf had no ID, bruh. You know what I'm talking about? ain't one nigga from my turf. I think the only nigga had an ID was Cole Pepper. Slim. Slim. JB might have had an ID. But everybody else, nigga, they went in and came and handed us the IDs and we got on up in there. But as soon as I got up in there, I didn't take a liking to that music they was playing. So we done already snuck in, right? Everybody way over there, baby, cuz up there fucking with the DJ looking through this nigga CD book. We gonna need something else over here, Pippin. You know what I'm talking about? This ain't it. This nigga up there playing hella Carl Thomas and shit, bro. We gonna need some, man, you gonna have to find that bitch that, that's what we found, too. That, your lies ain't working now. You know what I'm talking about, man? You gonna need something up in here we could rock with, man. But my people was hella mad. They turned around. They was like, bruh, nigga, yo, your motherfucking ass on. Like, you don't leave them people alone, nigga. We just got up in here, nigga. Bruh, nigga, I'm up there with the DJ on the spotlight, nigga. Hey, I know they over there like, man, look at this nigga here. But forever fought. And I lived the life of that shit, folks. It wasn't like and this was crazy because it's not like I tried to put fault on somebody else. You know what I'm talking about? I'm like, man, that wasn't my fault. Like, I wasn't really trying to blame nobody else. I was just saying it wasn't my fault. And you can't do that either, bro, because that's just as good as blaming somebody else. You got to see where your fault at, folks. Forever fault. That's where the lesson at. That's where the adjustments to be made at, folks. And we be running for life like that, folks. We do. We be running from life. We be running from our mistakes. We be running from our guilt. We be running. Now, mind you, because I'm still like that. So if you was to ever come around me and say the wrong thing, you know what I'm talking about? I might do the wrong thing. But, yeah, I got a few such I'm normal, bro. I'm a human. You know what I'm talking about? And I don't know why motherfuckers, bro, I'm a regular nigga from East Oakland, California, man. 7400 one way, MacArthur Bandits. You know what I'm talking about? I'm a regular person, bro. I'm the same nigga that went to Frick with y'all. Markham, E. Morris Cox, John Marshall. You know what I'm talking about? Frick, Fremont, Adult Day, you know what I'm talking about, East Side. Center, you know what I'm talking about, Rainbow. Yeah, I'm same nigga, bruh. But, Forever Fall Friday, you not gonna get it, bruh. It's just gonna be your fault sometime. And if you don't learn that and you try to run away from that, bruh, it's probably gonna be your fault more than often. Cause when you don't get what you doing wrong, you're gonna keep on doing wrong. You know what I'm talking about? You're gonna keep on repeating that shit. When you don't realize, because that's where the adjustment need to be made at most of the time. Where it's your fault. Whatever, bruh, and that shit come with everything, nigga, around the world. You might be eating too much, not eating enough, sleeping too much, not sleeping, your weight, your health, just that shit come with everything, bruh. But you'll never fix nothing until you see where you wrong at. But we just creating a world where we don't want to be wrong. We don't, so it ain't gonna never be our fault. Forever fault. It's just forever. It's gonna be somebody else's fault. What they shouldn't have did. What they should have did. You know what I'm talking about? Coffee Chronicles. You know, brothers up here, I ain't trying to tell you nothing, but I can tell you where all that shit is dangerous at, cause it doesn't do anything for you. Now look, cause it took me a long time. It took me a long time, bro. I was just a little bit ignorant a few years ago, folks. Maybe about 2 or 3 years ago, bruh. Right when I started this YouTube station. I'm trying to think. Did I go to, I think I went to jail for the last time before I started my station. I think I started my station right after that. But, yeah, I was just, you know what I'm talking about? And that shit's still somewhere up in there. It is. That'd be the scary part about being a person. It really don't be y'all. It be trying to stop yourself from doing certain shit, to put yourself in certain situations. That shit really don't have nothing to do with y'all. You know what I'm talking about? You ever heard somebody say, I ain't even worried about you. I'm scared what I'm going to do. If you ever heard somebody say that, leave them alone. That used to be an old person saying. My daddy told me that shit. when I was little, he said, man, you better not never, and I mean not never worry about a motherfucker. You better make a motherfucker worry about what you would do. Coffee Chronicles. Coffee Chronicles. I took heed. But forever fault. Bro, sometimes you just gonna do some wrong shit. Sometimes you just gonna do some dumb shit. Sometimes you just gonna do some emotional shit. You know what I'm talking about? And you gotta look back at that shit that you did. Cause if you don't go over that shit gonna keep going over you. You know what I'm talking about? You gonna keep putting yourself in the same situation somehow. With different shit, no matter where you at, somehow you still gonna be ending up in the same situations. You know what I'm talking about? Cause nowadays, more than ever, we run off emotions. Mama say breast on biscuits when you on TV. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, nowadays emotions is running rapid. You know what I'm talking about? So we run off emotions a lot now. You feel me? So however we feeling at the time, that's the kind of person we is for the moment. Coffee Chronicles. And that's where y'all most fucked up at in this day and age. You know what I'm talking about? Because it's like say you knew a motherfucker for 50 years, and the moment that motherfucker get mad, you're not even going to get the benefit of the 50-year relationship that you this motherfucker had. You're going to have to deal with the fury of all that emotional ass shit right then and there, bruh. And that's why I tell you niggas get more like hoes. You know what I'm talking about? And forever fault. What I don't understand, and what I don't understand about the nigga of today is how you can't even ask a nigga as a grown person to leave you alone. And I ain't never seen that in real person. I ain't never seen that. I ain't never seen normally, even if it was finna be a fight. I'm gonna tell you how I used to go, bruh. Say one nigga was hella mad. He had hella aggression, right? And he'll be like, nigga, come on. And the other nigga like, bro, I don't want to fight. I remember when there wouldn't be no fight. The other nigga might talk a little shit. That's what I thought with your scary ass. But I remember where a motherfucker was ready to fight and another motherfucker wasn't. That it wouldn't even be no fight. You know what I'm talking about? If the other nigga didn't accept the challenge, it wouldn't even be no fight. Now, they might call you all kind of marks, scary and all that shit, but I remember it wouldn't be no fight. You know what I'm talking about? Then gradually it went to, whether the nigga wanted to fight or not, he was finna get fired on. You know what I'm talking about? Then it kept gradually going. You know what I'm talking about? But I can actually remember that, folks. But now, bro, you can't even, like, as a grown person in the real world, you can't even be like, bro, I'm cool. A nigga would sit there and bother you, folks. A nigga would, like, you can't even tell a nigga to leave you alone. A nigga would sit there and bother you, folks. And start saying hella other shit after you ask a nigga to leave you alone. Just, oh, what's wrong? You mad? And that nigga start sounding just like your first baby mama, bro. Just start saying hella other shit. I'm not nothing, bro. I just want you to leave me alone. I don't be wasting my energy on all that shit right there, bro. You know what I'm talking about? I got some other shit to pay attention to. Oh, what, you mad? You guilty? You know what I'm talking about? Just go off like a bitch. I say, man, you niggas something straight out of the comic book, bro. I ain't never seen no shit like this. I ain't. We're a nigga, not the bitch. You know what I'm talking about? Not the bitch. But the nigga, like, sets out to agitate you. Like the bitch. Forever fault. Friday, man. But I keep telling y'all, man, you know when the world going in, when you pass, that's when the world going in. When you pass. So while you living, you know what I'm talking about? I don't know, grow yourself. Because I'm telling you, bro, it took me a long ass time. I ain't bullshitting with you. I told you just a few years ago. ain't high at all. My sense like that all like that. You know what I'm talking about? And but at some point, you gotta get tired of the results you getting. If you getting some fucked up results, or you not getting the results that you just want like that. You know what I'm talking about? At some point in time, you gotta, you just gotta be ready to buckle down and go on to something new. But on that Forever Fall Friday shit, bruh, if you're not ready to buckle down and shit and you just ready, it's never gonna be your fault, folks. So most likely, you're gonna be the one, you're gonna be the characterless person. You're going to be the one to come around trying to get everybody on your side. You're going to be the one always telling your version of the story. You know what I'm talking about? And when you tell your version of the story, like how everybody do, that's why it'd be 9 different stories on this one, bro. You tell the story from your perspective. Because a lot of us, we don't even have like objective thinking. So it's impossible to relate to shit how it actually happened. So we tell the story from however we trying to get you to see it. We don't really tell the story. We just tell it from the part where we try to get you on our side about the story we telling. You know what I'm talking about? Forever Fall Friday. And that shit just, to y'all nowadays, all that told you, I told you so, I was right. Like, a lot of that shit just means too much to people. Coffee Chronicles. It really don't even matter who right or wrong, folks. Now, I say that at the, on the point, I ain't talking about you just go out there and be fucking people over and you really scandalous and all that. But certain shit you do that people be trying to say, like selling dope. You can't say that's right or wrong. Doing anything illegal. Now, it's a law against it, but you can't say that's right or wrong. You know what I'm talking about? That shit is a matter of opinion. You feel me? That shit actually the same thing like my man be saying. You talking about it's wrong to sell dope or smoke or whatever you talking about. And you sitting right there going to Walgreens every day picking up that prescription. You get what I'm saying? It's the same shit. But the way they made you see it, you think it's a difference. But all that shit's the same shit. You know what I'm talking about? It really, like, you could say smoking bad, drinking bad. Like, that's just a matter of opinion. You know what I'm talking about? Anything you really do personally, as long as it's not, like, it's within the code, it ain't really going against nothing. You ain't stealing all that old other fuck shit, you know what I'm talking about? Backbiting, starting shit and all that. Coffee Chronicles. Somebody can't come tell you because they don't smoke. You shouldn't. You know what I'm talking about? All that shit right there be a matter of opinion. But y'all, Forever Fall Friday. And all that shit is accountability, really. You know what I'm talking about? That's all that shit be. But since that's why we don't really be responsible for ourselves. And that's why you find a lot of Forever Fall Friday motherfuckers. Because when you're not accountable for yourself, you ain't gonna never see what you did. You know what I'm talking about? Or even if you did it, you gonna always see the reason why you did it. Once again, that's the world we get into. It ain't even what you did no more. The doozer is the reason why you did it. And if you always come up with a reason why you always doing something, you always going to be doing something. Forever Fault. Because it ain't going to never be you. It's going to be like that old school shit. You made me, I remember when we was little and motherfuckers used to say that shit. You made me cheat. motherfucker make you cheat. That shit crazy as a motherfucker. You know what I'm talking about? That was a good one back then, right? Everybody used to use that one. You made me cheat. You know what I'm talking about? I motherfucker make you cheat, man, please. You ain't did nothing but find a reason to go fuck somebody you was wanting to go fuck on anyway, man. That's all that shit was. Forever fault. That's the invisible consequence. You gave somebody else. You keep on acting up. I'm going to go do this. But that's what you wanted to do anyway. Let me tell you something. Come here. There's no such thing as getting revenge on people. You know what I'm talking about? It didn't. It ain't. There's no such thing. Now, you could think it is, but there's no such thing as getting revenge on people. You know what I'm talking about? For one, God said vengeance was his. You know what I'm talking about if you read that Bible. For two, the moment you do something, that's where you start your karma at. You ain't gonna never get revenge on nobody, bruh. You just gonna do something for something to come back on you. Call me Chronicles. That's why I say before you do shit, man, you better realize the consequences, because there's a lot of them. Mama say brush your whiskers on TV. So you can never get revenge on nobody. All you gonna do is start your karma. I ain't bullshitting with you. Because everything you do, you got to pay for also. Also, you know what I'm talking about? See, that's what we don't get. In our mind, we'll tell ourselves we done did this shit because this is what they deserve. Once again, vengeance is God's. You got to let him take care of that, right? But the moment you go on and step your bad ass up and say, you know what? I'm going to take care of it myself. That shit you just put in the game you did to them people, that's the day you put that shit in the air to come back to you also. Remember that. You ain't never get revenge on nobody. You know what I'm talking about? You'll start a bad luck on yourself. That's why something now I know it's hard. That's why you gotta be ready to accept that consequence. Cause the game coming back. You know what I'm talking about? Told you nigga I gotta vote it 12, nigga, you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, nigga. Out of 4 to 12. You'll never be able to do nothing to get away with that shit, bro. You're going to pay for it, too. So be, just remember that, y'all, forever. On forever fault. You'll never be able to get away with nothing, bro. So just before you do anything, is you ready to accept the consequence that's going to come with the game, folks? That's what you got to really ask yourself. You know what I'm talking about? So you never really get away with nothing. Whether you tell, whatever you do, bro, that shit coming back to you. You know what I'm talking about? You can't put nothing in this motherfucking earth that ain't gonna come back to you. That's why you should watch what you put in this motherfucking earth. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't never did nothing, bro. And I got my ass spanked. You know what I'm talking about? Not nothing. So just watch what you do, because that shit gonna come back to you on this forever fault. Why you blaming other people, you know what I'm talking about? You could blame everybody all day about who fault it was and shit. Watch how that, watch how the universe play you. Or not play you, but watch the plate the universe has for you. So you could think you can get back and you can get your anger off and all that shit, you know what I'm talking about? You talking to a nigga who know how that shit is, for real, bruh. I can just tell you, man, that shit ain't gonna help you. It might help you momentarily. Man, look. This life ain't long. So the faster you learn to hurry up and do something, go sit your ass down some motherfucking where, the better off you gonna be. For real. And you know what killed me about the world? You gonna say what killed you about the world? Forever Fall Friday, bruh. Y'all sit here all day and talk about who haters and everybody. Now y'all say everybody all the time. Everybody. Everybody hating. everybody jealous, everybody there. And then they throw a big old bash. And y'all want to go hang out with everybody. I ain't never got that one. Y'all want to go hang out around the people y'all don't like. I don't even know why everybody don't like each other no more. I understand the gangs, but I'm just talking about the normal people. Huh? Y'all something straight out of comic book, bruh. Y'all reenact everything y'all see on TV. Y'all reenact everything y'all see on YouTube, social media. Y'all reenact everything. Forever Fault Friday. You know what I'm talking about? And I'm finna get up out of here because I got things to do. You know what I'm talking about? Nephew, sis, old man, old lady. Nephew, sis, old man, old lady. Hey, what's up, bro? Old lady. Hey, you know what I'm talking about? I ain't bullshitting with you. Worldwide, man. You know what I'm talking about? The finger. You know what I'm talking about? Swing that finger, young man. You know what I'm talking about? But for real, Forever Fault. So if you want the motherfuckers keep on, like I said, bro, you ain't got to listen to shit I say. You know what I'm talking about? You don't. But you just keep on. You keep on living the life where it ain't nobody's fault. You know what I'm talking about? You ain't did nothing. The reason you did this was because of that. Just keep on living the life like that and see where it gets you. Until you responsible for yourself, you ain't gonna be responsible for shit, bruh. I'm telling you, they could give you $50 million. You're gonna be broke in 2 days. You know what I'm talking about? You're gonna be broke in 2 days. They gonna find your ass. You know what I'm talking about? Nigga, you gonna be somewhere around Lacey, nigga, with your last $40 in the dice game, nigga. I ain't bullshitting, would you? The loss, man. Loss. But if you ain't responsible for yourself, bro, you ain't even ready to change nothing, bro. You gonna keep on having the same mistakes that you've always been having. Because you ain't gonna never understand them. Because you either did something for this reason, or it was them. You know what I'm talking about? Even though you the one. You done broke somebody's window. And they telling you, man, you done broke my window. And you trying to explain to them how they made you mad enough to break their window. But what do I know? Only you could prevent forest fires. And with that one right there, if you don't remember nothing else, always remember. It don't cost nothing just to show a